What's up, everybody? This is Tim, aka Rock Arky, bringing you guys a video because I tried doing this on Twitch and it was super pixelated. So what we're gonna do is we are gonna take and do a kind of a simulation of my deck, starting with this being, we're actually gonna count turns instead of counting my own health. Actually, I may want to go ahead and grab some life counters. We'll be right back. Alright guys, so we are back, and I have all my life counters from Magic the Gathering. Oh, hey, let's use you as my dude. So we're going to track the health. Basically what we're going to do is we're just going to play one half of the board, and we're just going to see how fast this deck, how much damage and how fast it can do it. I've done some heavy tweaking on this. I just tried to do it on Twitch, but it was super pixelated, so I figured I'm just gonna make a video and post this on YouTube. So here we are. So let's go ahead and get started. And we're gonna simulate this as if we were going on turn one, so we only get four cards instead of five, so we do have a card disadvantage at the beginning of the game. So if you've not played Lightseekers, the main objective of the game is to cast buffs, attacks, and defends. Defense will always help you, attacks will always hit your opponent, and then buffs will always give you bonuses towards your end game goal. Your end game goal is to get your opponent down to zero life, and hopefully this deck won't make it to where I die. Because I have taken it to where I like drawing cards so much that I'm willing to take a lot of damage. Alright. So this was already shuffled like a billion times anyway. So we got a hero here, Dole of the Mighty. His ability is gonna allow us to take two damage and draw two cards, and this is all from the Mountain Starter deck. What we're going to do is simulate and count what turn it is with these, one of these turn down die. And hopefully you guys can see this one. This is probably my best color one where you guys can see that. That's gonna be turn one. And as you turn this, the numbers are all in order on this. These are not D20s, they are life counters for Magic, but this is the easiest way to track the life. And then we have this guy right here, or not track life, but track what turn it is. And we have this guy right here showing you how much health I have. And I start at 31, so I'm going to turn this like this. So you guys can see the health tracker as it goes around. We don't have to worry about the red eye. Hopefully I won't do that while playing by myself. But we're going to start at 31 health. We have alignment mountain. And we have the elements of fire, earth, and crystal. Or volcanic, earthquake, and crystal. Or gems. There's technical terms, but you can call them whatever you want. So we're going to start this out as if I were playing on first turn, and that's a pretty good draw on the first turn. So first turn, we're going to get four cards. So I'm going to play my Chrono Wrangler on Dolo the Mighty, and then I'm going to do three damage to my opponent and draw a card. So that is three damage on my opponent. And I'm just going to put whatever I do damage-wise here. Against my opponent. We're now going to go to turn two. So on turn two, I'm gonna take two damage and then draw two cards. And then I still have one more action left and I'll go ahead and draw another card. So now we go to turn three. So let's see what's in my hand. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and play another Chronomoth. Dealing another three damage and drawing another card, my first action. And then I'm gonna go ahead and play an Ancient Miner. That's gonna allow me to draw cards. So we're on turn four. So Ancient Miner gonna rotate, allow me to draw a card. We're not cooking yet. So I'm going to go ahead and to deal six damage to my opponent and two to myself. Alright, so they're currently at 6, 9, 10, 11, 12 damage. Alright, so then that was only one action, wasn't it? Oh, we'll hold the last action and draw a card. I think that was my last action. Okay, so now we go to turn 5, and I'm going to count my actions on this guy. So 2 actions per turn, 5. So rotate this guy, get to draw 2 cards. Alright, for my first action, I'm going to play Tyrax Historian. And what we're going to do is I'm going to set that off to the side, and that off to the side, knowing that I need 2 fire and 2 crystals, 1 earthquake. So, I need that earthquake. I need the 3 fires. And the 2 crystals. So let's draw 3 cards. 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna decide to just keep everything I have in my hand, put these 2 back off of the Tyrax Historian. Sorry if I'm not talking loud enough. It's like 1 a.m. I think. And I'll do another one of these videos when I'm not as tired or wore out. I'm really tired. That's probably why I'm doing this. Okay. So, first action, exhausted. Second action, we're going to take 2 damage and draw 2 cards. So that's going to take us to turn 6. This is going to go over to here. This is going to rotate out, and this would actually be in this order. No, it wouldn't. It'd be in this order, because Tyrax and Historian would have been resolved as soon as I played it. Alright, so now we're going to play Wrath of the Mountain. Why not? And we are going to pour in the Crushing Blow combo into this. So the fire, the earthquake, and a crystal. So I only need 1 more crystal, so I'll play this crystal, dealing the 12 damage to my opponent. And these 2 will get shuffled in. And then after I shuffle this, I get to draw a card because I played a combo, and then that ends my turn. So that was my 2 actions. So let's say my opponent cut my deck. And then I draw a card. Okay, what is that card? So we did that. That's neat. So now it's the next turn, turn 7. I'm gonna play a Shatter Flame, and I'll pay for that with the Everrock Crystal and or Everrock Relic and Crystal Bat. So those are gonna go into my hand, or not in my hand, but in my deck. They're gonna get shuffled, and I played a combo this turn, so that takes up both of my actions, and I'm gonna draw a card. My deck, and I draw a card. Okay. So it passes turn, comes back to me. Boom. 12 damage to the face. So right now, we can only have a cap of 35. We're on turn 7. I've done 12, 18, 21. 24 plus 12, 36. So, I've done 36 total damage so far. This is gonna rotate out. We're gonna go turn 8. And we're gonna pretend that our opponent is still alive. And we're gonna do another 5 damage on turn 8. And then we're gonna do another 3. Oh, I can't do that because it's not this correct symbol. So we'll play we'll just take 2 and draw 2. So now it's gonna go to turn 9. And hopefully, you know, by this time your opponent is already dead. that's a buff. And then I'm gonna play. Oh, I can't play two earthquakes. Alright, so then we'll do another flame bat to our opponent. So, let's see how much damage we've done. Because you also have to think about tech. When they have a heal, they have like nitro healing. I think it's like 13. So, you know, you have to calculate that they're going to take 13. So we've done 5, 10, that would be 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45. So 45 damage. So if they started out even at a decent, at 31, got killed, went up 13, healed up to 35, we did 46. You know, you've done 10 damage over, you're probably gonna get there. So this is gonna allow me to draw a card, and then there's another flame bat, and while you're still doing damage, and you're, you know, it's turn 10, and we've done, that would put us over the 47 mark with that flame bat. We have other things to cancel their attack, so this buff, like if they wanted to play an attack to get rid of this buff, this would cancel it out. We have a Colossi Ritual Site, which has increased damage done to other heroes, which probably would have been played somewhere in there. And then we have 6 healing, and then we have 2 Everrock Relics in our hand. So if we take 2 damage and draw 2 cards, there's another Magma Spitter for 6 damage. I would take 2. And then the next turn, take 2. Well, we would have drawn 2 off of this guy, so we would have had more arsenal in our hands. So we would have had another Chronomoth, deal 3 damage, draw a card, and then a Crystal Bat, deal 3, heal 3. So this deck has a lot more aggro, a lot more damage coming out of it, and the combos are more payable. I still have my Rock Bomb in here that is a red and orange. I'm still playing my Tantosian Blacksmith just so that I can get my foily equipment out. Now this guy, an item, as soon as this item hits the field, I have access to both my colors. This is only dual color. It was triple colored, but it was an anti-buff deck, and now it's draw card, deal damage. So I like it, but here's my Rock Bomb. I don't know if you guys have seen one of these or not, but I'm sure if you play the game a lot, you've probably seen one. And I'm sorry that I'm really tired, you know. It was 2 in the morning, I was bored, I didn't want to go to bed. But, so yeah, so turn 10, we're doing almost 50 damage. This deck did used to have a possible win turn 2 condition, but that was when I was running 3 colors and it was just crazy. I'm sure that that's still capable. Like if we have enough cards in our hand and stuff like that, we could probably win really quick. But I haven't built anything that like stuff will stack and then build combos off of it and stuff like that. And I know that people can do big damage, but this game doesn't have where you can fetch cards other than just the item to get to your second color. So I can either run into this or fetch it out, but that's really the whole, I don't know, like Tyrax Historian, he doesn't really do anything. He lets me draw 3 cards, but then I have to put 2 of anything in my hand after drawing back, so it's not a big deal. Like, I don't know, I just like drawing cards, and in a game where you have to burn actions to draw those cards, I think this deck is kind of unique because I can deal 3 damage, draw a card off of the Monocroth or whatever the name is. Mono Moth? Oh, I put my hero in there. Some kind of Moth. Chronomoth. So the Chronomoth, and then there's, like for drawing, I have 3 Ancient Miners. The Chronomoth deal damage to draw. I don't know. I think it's a fun deck. Maybe eventually I'll build something that's like a top tier competitive thing. but I don't know. I'm just having fun with it right now. But I think a lot of damage like that coming constantly. I know there's a lot of aggro tech stuff out there, but you okay? She must be okay. She didn't. She must be okay. She didn't, like, fall off the couch or anything. But, yeah, that's it. I just wanted to kind of, like, show you what it can do within the first 10 turns. So it's, like, a lot coming at you at once. Now, if I somehow figure out ways of building these decks like I did in Magic, then the turnout can be catastrophic. But I like red, and now red is doing burn like it's supposed to. And I get to draw cards in red. That's something you don't do in Magic, so I like that you can draw with red. And I can burn my opponent quickly. I'm sure in a 1v1 match, you know, 10 turns goes by real quick, especially when it's two actions. You know, stuff goes off. But, yeah, I took out most of my buff removal, so Dread, Nature, you guys can have fun again, I'll let you play. But eventually I'm gonna build my anti-deck to be much better, to where I can actually win and keep buffs off the field. Because this deck was three colors and it had 15 removals, and then I was gonna change cards to where I could actually get up to 20 removals in a game. So between cards and combinations of rotating buffs, so buffs and attacks were gonna allow me to get rid of a lot of stuff. But yeah, that's it. So I'll see you guys later. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys are interested in playing Lightseekers, you can get a hold of your local game store, ask them about carrying it and holding events and all that jazz. So look for it. It's also available on Amazon. You can also get the cards at Toys R Us, I believe, still. It's still posted on the website, so it's a good game. I like it a lot, and I like to play it constantly. Anna, she likes playing it, but she doesn't want to keep playing it. She doesn't want to get burnt out on it, so I don't know. I can play this nonstop and have no burning out, because then I'll be like, oh, there's a card that I realized I could put in my deck. Also, when you're building a deck, there's decks out there that are like, we call them a net deck because everybody would build it, but build your deck for what you want it to do. Don't be worried about what everybody else does, because you can't have an answer for everything. I mean, you can, but your deck probably won't win that way. So have a goal. Your goal is to get your opponent down to zero. So if you're gonna build an aggro tech deck, there's that, it's fast. Gets there and it's quick, or you can kind of build it how I did. Now, if I took the draw cards out and put more tech damage cards in there, I could probably make it faster on dealing damage and just destroying someone. But I also like to draw cards, so that's just one thing I like to do, is draw cards. So, all right. I'm gonna get off here. I guess I'm gonna go to sleep. I think. Bye. Sorry, I was boring.